Hi, I am Precious Machas, BSN2-2. Today, I am going to perform starting an IV infusion. First, we're going to assess the vital sign of the patient so that we have the baseline of the data. Next is to assess the skin turgor so that we can validate if the patient can receive an IV or inject an IV in her skin. This is how to assess skin turgor of the patient or the client. First is to pinch a little bit, and then if it does not return back to normal, then the patient is dehydrated and we need to rehydrate. So in this case, the patient has a good skin turgor because it comes back easily. Next is we need to assess if the patient is allergic to or have an allergy to the tape or the iodine to make sure that the patient does not or will not be irritated once we apply the tape or iodine solution. Next is to assess the bleeding tendencies. We need to make sure that the bleeding tendencies are very low or does not have any bleeding tendencies at all, so that the patient will have a very smooth experience when they have an IV infusion in their body. Next thing we need to assess are disease or injury to extremities. We need to assess those first because we need to make sure that the injection site or the IV site of the patient can correspond or is comfortable when we inserted it. Last to assess is the status of veins to determine the appropriate venipuncture site. So we need to properly assess the veins so that we can insert the venipuncture or the needle smoothly or as fast as possible. Things that we need to consider. First is how long the patient is likely to have an IV. Next is what kind of fluids will be infused. Lastly, what medication the patient will be receiving or is likely to receive. Next is we should assemble the equipment. Since that I do not have enough resources, I'm going to show pictures of the materials that are needed in this demonstration. First is infusion set, container of sterile parenteral solution, IV pole, adhesive or non-allergenic tape, clean gloves, tourniquet, antiseptic swab, intravenous catheter. The intravenous catheter, we should always consider the variant of the intravenous catheter if we're going to use the butterfly needle. Sterile gauze dressing or transparent occlusive dressing. Next is arm splint if required. We're only going to use arm splint if the patient is always moving their hands because the blood may go inside the IV tubing or there will be backflow. So we always need to consider if we're going to put a splint on the patient. First thing that we need to do is introduce myself and verify the client's identity, then explain the procedure to the client. To avoid confusion or so that the patient is aware of what we are going to do. Hi ma'am, I'm your nurse. I am Precious. Are you Maria Isabel?
Yes.
Okay, so what we are going to do is to insert an IV in your veins because you're going to need the needed nutrients in your body since you are going to be admitted in this hospital. Is that okay, ma'am? Okay, I'm going to prepare na po yung mga gamit and then I'm going to wash my hands, okay po? Okay, next is we're going to provide the client's privacy and close the curtains. Imagine that I already washed my hands. So what we're going to do is to open the IV infusion set. Imagine that I have gloves or sterile gloves. I'm going to open it like so. And this is the IV infusion set. So this is where we are going to insert the bag or the IV fluid. So this is how long the set is. So I don't have the bag. First thing that we're going to do is to remove the cup. Make sure not to touch the spike where we're going to insert the fluid. Next is we're going to open this IV fluid. Let's just imagine that this is an IV fluid. There you go. Imagine that I spike it and insert the like this. Insert this spike like this, like so. Let us imagine that there is an IV fluid dripping on this IV infusion set. After we saw dripping, we're going to hang the IV on the IV pole. Let us imagine that there's an IV pole. So, after that, we're going to adjust. Then, we're going to partially fill the container of this IV infusion set. Then, imagine that this is already partially filled. Next is we're going to prime the IV tubing. Next we need to do is to determine the IV infusion site. So let us check the veins first. And if we determine the IV infusion site, we're going to dilate the vein using this. So what we're going to need is to make sure that it is tight. Make sure that but not too tight. The tourniquet is tight but not too tight. Just to make sure that the veins is dilated like this. There you go. She has a nice vein. Next is we're going to clean the IV infusion site using a sterile swab. What we're going to do is to clean the site inner to outer. There you go, and let it dry down. Do not fan the IV infusion site. Since we do not have an instructor beside us or professor beside us, we are only stopping until the prepping of the vein. So that's it.